not just building, it's much more complicated than just building. There are processes that can be done. In Pennsylvania, they were doing some basic filter, not complete by any means, and then discharging that filtered waste into the river. And they found that over time, it was having a cumulative negative impact on the river. So they changed the process to say that the companies have to filter that water, process or treat water, to a standard that isn't pure, but it's to a standard of drinking water. And the companies in Pennsylvania have decided that it's simply not economic. But the process is part of it.
Well, the thing again is that when the industry, the fracking and the waste injection well, industry said that the liquid is not toxic. Well, it was toxic enough in the state of Pennsylvania has decided they will not allow it to be disposed of in their state.
Yeah.
Okay, we have another vehicle that needs to be removed. This one is a license plate. It's a black Jeep Cherokee. License plate is DIL8155. DIL8155. Okay, the next question is, DNR declined any well requests.
Yes, I don't have a number for you, but as that company makes an application to us, I told you there's 177 injection wells that are currently drilled in the mine. The companies that do this will typically call our injection control program and let it be known that they are wanting to receive a permit for a particular location. So what we oftentimes do is the area review study before the company makes an application. If that area review shows that the permit would not be issued if it were submitted, then the companies don't apply for a permit. They won't get it in that case anymore. If we find, once the application is received, that there is an area review or a contaminant potential, then we deny that application because of that risk of upward migration contaminants.
If I may ask, in terms of evaluating whether a permit would be issued, does ODNR require, and does ODNR do this due diligence to determine what the assets of that company are? Because if a permit is granted and that company then injects the waste fluid, they cause contamination, they don't have the resources to clean it up, then we have a problem. So does ODNR check the financial capability of assets of the company fund for the permit?
No. The financial records of the company are not reviewed during these processes. The companies are required to have a $3 million insurance policy to cover this. All claim policies, not single claim policies. So the insurance is used to offset any of the potential damages that could occur. And the company is liable for that property.
Okay, I think this question is directed to a drone respond, and why is the citizens outside of the city of Mansfield not able to vote on or determine whether injection wells are placed inside Mansfield? And I think it could be a drone respond, and anybody else wants to respond?
Well, presently as the law is written, no one apparently has the right in the state of Ohio to vote to reject the injection wells or to determine where they're going to be placed. So the first answer is no one has the right or the voice by vote to object to the director's ability in our test of granting the permit and the placement of the permit. By way of sort of a historical perspective of this, generally speaking, this whole industry really only started in 2008. The techniques existed to some extent. So roughly in 2008, there was this general proclamation that we now could frack, obtain, make available natural gas sources that weren't economically previously worth doing. Since then, they have drilled 3,800 fracking wells in Pennsylvania. And I somewhat disagree with the ODNR, the state of Ohio's projection, that maybe we've hit a limit on the amount of the injection for fracking fluid that will need to find a place like Ohio and Mansfield for injection. Because what we know is that yesterday there was an announcement by a utility company in Pennsylvania that they were going to spend just next year, this year, 2012, $1.7 billion in 1 year for further oil and gas exploration. 900,000 of that, excuse me, 900 million of that is going to be expended for new fracking wells, which was exploded in the waste. So we have a law that came into being that says we know that the ODNR has total exclusive jurisdiction to determine those issues. Legally, we disagree with that because we think a potentially valid issue is that the Ohio Constitution guarantees has an inalienable right of each citizen of Ohio to the right to safety. And we think that the right to freedom from the risk of earthquake, or the right to be free from the risk of contamination, when we see little or no benefit as a right that we have demanded that we serve, probably be recognized that it has to be.
The next question is, why is fracking wastewater not classified as a class one injection?
Under federal code, under the Resource Conservation Recovery Act, the waste streams are broken into classes, and then those classes are assigned to different types of animals. Certain classes of waste are classified as class one. They may be class one hazardous or class one non-hazardous. Those are typically defined as industrial type waste. From chemical plants, manufacturers, and that type of operation. A class two waste, according to the RCRA code, is oil field waste. And oil field waste would include any of the fluid waste that are generated during the drilling of oil, and it wouldn't matter whether it was professional or injection oil. During the completion of the well, fracking occurs at a production well, but not an injection well. The operation or plugging of a particular well. So if it fits that waste stream,